Hi friends, welcome to Yuvaguru Maths Theory Lectures. We have theory and practical, two separate types of video lectures. In theory we cover the concepts and in practical we cover the examples. Both this theory and practical together are useful for CBSE, ICSE, various state boards across India and outside India as well. Anyone who wants to understand maths properly needs to download this Yuvaguru Maths Olympiad app. Let's start today's topic. Today we are studying practical geometry. Now what is practical geometry? Practical means practical, means construction. We have to construct something, right? So here we'll be focusing mainly on quadrilateral. So quadrilateral, how to construct a quadrilateral? It's easy to construct a quadrilateral when five measurements are known. Five. Now what they are five? Any five they can be. Like length of four sides and length of one diagonal. Length of three sides, length of two diagonals, and three angles and two adjacent sides. If three sides and two angles are known, and there are special types of diagonals also. So let's start with the quadrilateral when four sides and one diagonal are known. So four sides, see this, in this PQRS, PQ4, QR6, RS5 and PS5 means all the four sides are known, and PR is a diagonal, this we know as 7. So how to do it now? So very simple, first draw the diagonal 7, right? Then you draw, take the compass and make an arc of 4. Then take the compass from R and make an arc of 6. Now you know this point Q, so you got PQR. Now similar, same logic, take over this side, see this 4 and 6, okay? Then same logic, take this S point, make an arc of 5.5 over here, 5 over here, and join it. That's it, constructed. Okay, these are quite simple. Once you understand and if you know the basics of geometry, then of arcs, cutting the arcs and taking the points, it's very simple. Three sides and two diagonals. Okay, see here, three sides are known, AB, AD and AC. Okay, now you don't know, you don't have anything over here, this picture, right? AC and BD and BC are known, means this BD is a diagonal and BC is a side, and here AC is a diagonal. So what we do is, see this, always start from that side which whose ends you know something about the ends, means see this, if you take AB, then do you know something about A? AD you know, AC you know, so two things you know starting from A. Now regarding B, you know BD and BC, so again two things you know starting from B. Even if you know one point starting from something, then you can start from that segment or that side. Okay, so start with AB. Now you know AB, draw the 7, then from A take the compass, make an arc of 6, right? And then take the point of compass at B, make an arc of 7.5, cut it, you know AD now, join ADB, you have joined. Similarly for C, take an arc of 4 and take an arc of 7 from A and B, right? Cut them and then you will get this point C, now join it. Okay, so always try for that side. Well, see, the main problem is which side to start with. Always try to start from that side whose ends you know something about those ends. Okay, now three adjacent sides and two adjacent sides and three angles we know. Now remember, two adjacent sides, okay, adjacent means just near to each other, okay, means starting from one point. Okay, let's start. AL 6.5 we know, LP 4 we know. See, these are the two adjacent sides, AL and LP, starting from L, and three angles we know, NAL, ALP and LPN. Now which side should I draw now, AL or LP? So again try for the same logic. A is one end, L is another end, L is one end, P is another end. But what do you know angle NAL over here, so A is in between, so something you know about this point A, right? So you can start with AL in that case. Similarly LP also you know, ALP, you can start with LP also, anything will do in this case. Okay, so draw AL 6.5. Now you know the angles, right? Which angle you know? you know this NAL. So L you know, A you know. So it takes 110 degrees and mark, take one ray from here. End. Okay. You know ALP also. Take one AL you know. Take 75 degrees and take one ray from here. Okay. So two rays you have got now. Now what you want is this point P. You know LPN is 90. And what do you know? Two adjacent sides. AL you have drawn. Now LP you know. Take an arc of LP 4 and mark it over here. Right. Now the point P you know. Now you have to draw this line. This line is 90 degrees. Right. It's given LPN 90. Take 90 degrees and draw it. That's it. Even if you start with LP, you will get the same result. Only the this quadrilateral will be tilted. Okay. Tilted to the right side. Now if you know three sides and two included angles, then see this, three sides AB, BC, CD. These three sides we know, two included angles ABC and BCD. Okay. So AB, you know something about the end B? Yes, you know over here ABC, you know, right? See, this B is in the center of this angle. It means you can use this AB side as one part. Now BCD also, this same is for BC also, BCD. So you know something about BC and C also over here, right? So you can start with anyone, AB or BC. Let's start with BC. Draw a line BC of segment 3.5, then angle LBC 45, then angle BCM 150. Okay, this is simple. With B as a center and radius equals to 4.5, cut an arc on ray LB at A, right? This this which we have drawn, LB, cut an arc of 4.5. With C as a center and radius equals to 5, cut an arc on the ray CM at point D. Now join AD. ABCD is the required quadrilateral. See this, BC, then BCD, angle you know, then the angle ABC you know. So A you can draw it from here, BA. This ray you can draw. Now we don't know these lengths. Now what we do, we know the rays. So what we do is we take the lengths and cut those arcs, and that's it. Once those arcs are drawn, cut, then the points are, means we get the points. Now one special quadrilateral. Special means what? Something about which we know about the name itself. Construct a rhombus PQRS. Now rhombus means what? Once the name rhombus comes, you means it means all the sides are equal, right? And diagonals you know, 5.2 and 6.4, they are given. Okay, only diagonals are given. Now one point about rhombus is what? The diagonals are always perpendicular bisector of each other. Perpendicular bisector, okay? So first you draw PR or QS, anything. Start with PR, let's say. First draw PR, take the center, means using that compass, and you get the center perpendicular bisector over here. Now what do you want? You want this QS 6.4, because PR you have already got 5.2, right? Now QS you want 6.4. Now see, half of 6.4 is 3.2. Take the compass, put the arc over here, put the point over here, mark 3.2 on this ray, mark 3.2 on this ray. So you have got this 6.4 now. That's it, done. PQRS, you got this rhombus. In exams, you don't only get to give the steps for drawing this, but you also get to rearrange the steps or find the mistakes in the steps. That is solved in the practical videos. Kindly follow the practical videos. They are very important, because practice is the only thing which will give you the confidence. So that was the theory about practical geometry. Download Yuvaguru Maths Olympiad app from Play Store to get these videos, tests, question banks with explanations directly on your mobile. These video lectures contain two types of videos. One is theory and second is practical. Theory covers the concepts and practical covers the examples. Both this theory and practical together are useful for CBSE, ICSE, various state boards across India and outside India as well. Anyone who wants to understand maths properly needs to download this Yuvaguru Maths Olympiad app. Follow us on Facebook and WhatsApp us on this number for any query related to purchases. Keep studying, keep watching. Thanks.